out there. This is Steven from KiwiBox.com. We're outside on the patio of Kiwi Box offices in New York City, sitting with Sonya Kitchell. How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing lovely. So your new album, The Storm, just came out. It's also one of the tracks on the album. How come you decided to name the album after the song title?
Well, I chose that song as the title track because it's one of my favorite songs on the record, and I felt like the idea that the record is a storm is kind of cool because it's like something is brooding and something is happening, and before and after storms, it's this really interesting time. Before a storm, you feel like something's coming, and after, everything is really clean and sometimes torn apart. And the idea that the music is perhaps like that, like tearing layers back and revealing stuff and brooding and just the whole motion of a storm.
So on this record, you also worked with Malcolm Burns. What was it like working with him?
It was wonderful. I really love him. And it was a great experience because he absolutely pushed me to make the best record I feel like I could make at this point in my life.
You recorded the album at Malcolm's house and studio in Kingston, New York. Do you think that the environment influenced the sound of the record at all, or the way that you went in recording it?
Absolutely. I mean, his house is this big old kind of haunted mansion in Kingston, and it's filled with hats and peacock feathers and old pianos and music boxes and a little dog and cat and his wife, and you feel like you're in some kind of altered universe up there.
So this past summer you toured with Herbie Hancock, the legend. What was it like touring with him?
It was amazing. A really special experience because I got to spend the last 3 months around this man who is a living legend and just one of the most incredible human beings and teachers. And just, I think one of the biggest things I took from that experience is how he is as a human being. He's a really compassionate, generous person. And he's a Buddhist, and we chanted every day together, and we, at the end, we're chanting twice a day. And he really affected me greatly in that way, and how I saw how a leader of a band treated and treats all the people around him, and how it's something, you know, I as an artist would like to do.
So you're also about to embark on a huge fall U.S. tour. Are you ready to get back on the road just yet, or are you taking your time off and enjoying it?
Well, I'm not really off, so. No, I mean, so I'm on the road already, really. It's kind of, I left my apartment 3 months ago, 4 months ago now, and I knew that I was going to be out and on the road for about 8 months. So I've had a couple weeks now of not touring, but still doing stuff. So yeah, I'm ready to go back out because I'm already out, so to speak.
Do you have any surprises in store for this tour?
Well, we don't have any surprises in store yet. Specifically, I'm touring with The Slip, which is really exciting for me because they're this fantastic band. And I think it's going to be a really excellent show because we've been working very hard to put together a good show. And I've recently become obsessed with feathers and light bulbs and all sorts of random things. So I'm trying to figure out how I can incorporate that into the show to make it more of an experience.
And any plans for after the tour wraps up?
Finding an apartment somewhere and settling down again for a little while.
Do you know what city you'd like to be in?
Well, I was living in New York, so I'll probably come back to New York.
Great. Well, we will be happy to have you here. And thank you so much for meeting with us today.
Hello, this is Sonya Kitchell, and you're watching me on Kiwi Box.